Sunday Adelaja here. Kyiv, Ukraine. Happy Sunday to all of you. How was your day? Welcome, welcome everyone. Welcome. Is the notification out? Anybody there already? Are you ready for us? Are you ready for the move? Shegun Fatumo, as usual. Obi Ojimadu, blessed. Matthew Malandela, it's very clear that he's from South Africa. Bebe Ndum, Damilare, welcome. Rochelle White, blessings. Herbert Agudose, Tiger Diepre, Wamaka Oseje, Abby Kosh, Fleur Karin, David Omidaran, Ifeoma, Oluwatoyin, blessings. Jude, Sammy Kizito, Noah Folani, welcome. Welcome to all of you. GG7, hi. Welcome, welcome. Georgia Oscar, welcome. Ayodeji Solomon, welcome. Yetunde, you are back. Charles Smith, blessing. Okay, Emma Emejuru, blessing. John Conan, thank you. Magnus, Pastor Magnus, welcome. All right. Welcome to another great experience. Nikki Christian, is going to be a great experience today. Good evening. Vania, thank you. Welcome, nice to see you. Vim, from the Philippines. Elias, Charles Ushe, Esther, Layo Charles, Noah, Olorunfemi, Yetunde, Yetunde is talking about sharing. Okay, Muyiwa Ohis, Victor Eze, blessings to you. Andrew Shegu, welcome. Welcome to a great experience today. Well, I would like you to go look for your share button. And let's go and begin to share the button, the message, the link, because it's going to be a unique experience. Wale, welcome. Comfort Ngozi, Friday Otopa, welcome as well. Jot Idowu, welcome. So if you have not shared the link yet, go look for the link. Ijeoma, welcome. And let's go and share the link and invite everybody. Pastor, what's our discussion? Our discussion is about the kingdom of God, about taking the kingdom of God to everywhere, taking the kingdom of God to conquer the earth. Ladi Shorunke, Sarah Simeon, Pavel Semshuk, Olukayo De, Pavel Semshuk, to which is a говорил по-английски вижу. Good evening, Pastor. Olukayo De, Kundayo. Yes. Good evening, Ernest Ebong, Ruby. Link already shared. Okay. If you have already, Adebayo is here as well. Welcome. If you have already shared the link, I want to continue to talk about what we discussed yesterday. I announced to you yesterday, Magnolia, welcome. Ready to receive. Well, you remember yesterday I made an announcement that, and I ask you people, I ask all of you, what do you think? Do we need practical manifestation and practical testimonies of all these teachings I've been giving you about the kingdom? Is it really necessary to bring out people who are actually carrying the kingdom of God? People who are not pastors, just ordinary members of the church who have been taught to become kingdom carriers, who have been taught to carry the kingdom of God and who are actually carrying the kingdom of God. So that's why I want to, I've invited just a few people. They just came to visit me. So if they are not prepared people, I didn't know they were going to be here. And they just came up and I just called them up to come and share how they are carrying the kingdom of God. This will be an incredible experience to all of you. You will begin to hear not just Pastor Sunday's words. You don't need to believe me. Just believe the stories you hear, because ordinary people can have more influence ordinary people can influence more people than a whole church that is only carrying the gospel of salvation. But when a church is carrying the gospel of the kingdom, each person in that church could have more influence in 1 year over the world and bringing the kingdom than a whole church could have in 50 years. A church of 10 people that are aware of kingdom principles and have been taught, where those 10 people have been taught to carry the kingdom of God, that church with 10 people, we have more people, we have more influence, we have more power, more authority, more influence than a church of 1 million that has not been taught to carry the kingdom of God. So today, it's just your regular people from the church who are not ministers, who are not pastors, they are going to come around and they are going to share their stories of how the kingdom of God has affected them, how they have experienced the kingdom, and how they are now carrying the kingdom. That we are going to be doing every weekend. We're going to be doing this every Saturday and every Sunday. Just 2 days a week, every weekend, every Saturday and Sunday in the evenings, we are going to be having practical stories for you. I mean, these stories, you will just wonder, where are these kind of churches coming from? You just wonder. So get ready. There are many churches like this in the world. I doubt it. Personally, I've not seen any, whereby every member of the church is the one carrying the kingdom of God. So that's why we actually need to come to you with this practical manifestation, so that you know it's possible. Members of the church can change a nation. Members, ordinary members of the church can change the whole continent. We can change the world. We are the sons, we are the deliverers, we are the saviors that God is expecting to carry the kingdom of God to the end of the world. And that's what's unique about what God is doing in the embassy of God. That's why the embassy of God has become a model of the kind of church that Jesus actually wants to see in this world, whereby every member of the church is equipped to leave the church, to be released from the pews of the church, so that they could carry the kingdom of God to wherever they are. Let's start with the beautiful lady here that is called Maria. Maria is her name. Hello, Maria.
Hi, everybody. My name is Maria Kovalyova, but I speak in Russian today yet.
Okay. I will translate.
Спасибо, пастор. Конечно, очень многим хочется поделиться на самом деле, и очень рада сегодня быть с вами.
So many stories, so many things that I could share with you, that I would like to share with you, and it's such a joy to be with everybody today.
Я думаю, что очень классная идея, что вы сможете услышать эти свидетельства, потому что их в нашей церкви очень много.
It's a wonderful idea that pastor decided to invite members of our church to share the stories and the testimonies with you, because we have so many stories in this church, so many testimonies.
Yeah.
They are greeting you. Hello, Maria.
Thank you. Но каждый из нас 100% является результатом того, что для пастора никогда не было важно, сколько людей приходит в церковь, но для него было важно, какое влияние царство оказывает на общество.
Pastor has always been saying this, that it doesn't matter how many people that comes to church, even though we have a mega church, but he's always been saying, what matters is our influence. What influence to bring to the kingdom of God? I mean, how do we influence the city? How do we influence the country? And that our effectiveness should be measured in how much we change our country, how much our country is transformed through us. So it's not that we have a crowd of people, a mega church. Mega churches don't matter if they don't change their nations, if they don't change the economy, if they don't change politics, if they don't change business, entertainment, industry and everything. It doesn't matter how many people you have in your church.
И Царство Божье – это поле, на которое Иисус сеет семена, а семена – это цены Царства, которыми мы и являемся.
The Bible tells us that the children of God are the seeds of the kingdom. So the church is supposed to be about sowing not just the word of God, but the church is supposed to be sowing the seeds of the kingdom. The seeds of the kingdom are the sons of the kingdom. So the duty of the local church is to be sowing sons into every segment and every sphere of society.
Yes. И еще в 2006 году я приехала из маленького города в церковь посольства Божьего в Киев, человеком, который даже не умела жить.
И не знала Бога лично, да?
Знала уже Бога, ходила в церковь, но жить не умела, что такое царство,
ten,
вообще не понимала.
10 years ago I came to Kyiv from a village, from a small town, a village where I didn't even know how to live. I didn't understand life at all. So I came to pastor in such a state of somebody who is lost in life, who doesn't know his left from his right. He doesn't know how to live life.
Спустя минуту я приведу несколько примеров о том, как принципы утверждения царства и как менталитет царства сработал в моей жизни, и приведу конкретное свидетельство. Но сейчас...
Сначала, как царство тебя изменило?
Да.
First of all, I want to I will be giving you concrete examples. I'll be showing you concrete examples of how I am using the kingdom, how the God is using me to impose the kingdom of God, to bring the kingdom of God to change our country. But before then, I just want to share a few things about myself.
То есть в 2006 году я была человеком, которая не имела собственных принципов, не имела внутреннего стержня. Я даже не умела сказать «нет» на предложения, от которых нужно было отказываться, которые были опасны для меня.
I was growing up just as a young girl in the society, just like every other young girl in this culture. I didn't know how to say no to the peer pressure. I didn't know how to say no to bad things that might affect my life dangerously. I was just a vegetable that was just alive, just walking about, just doing what the whole society is doing, just being like everybody else.
Да, таких людей очень много, и такое мышление, неумение жить привело к тому, что я попала в большие проблемы, которые привели к моему полному разочарованию в жизни.
And because I didn't know how to live, I was not taught how to live, even though I had known the Lord Jesus Christ at this time, I just knew religion. I didn't know how to use the principles of the kingdom to build my life. I didn't know how to apply the kingdom rules of the kingdom of God. And so, I fell into problems after problems that almost destroyed my life.
И я приехала в город Киев на 12-ю годовщину церкви впервые и была потрясена тем, что рассказывали люди на этой годовщине. Я слышала массу свидетельств о том, как Бог изменил радикальным образом жизни людей и что они теперь делают в обществе. Я была потрясена.
The greatest shock for me in the Embassy of God Church when I came here was the amount of stories of transformed lives. I mean, you cannot believe the kind of testimonies that abound in this church. In most churches of the world, you only hear people talk about testimonies of healing, prosperity, how God blessed them. But in the Embassy of God, the kind of stories you'll be hearing is how destinies are changed, how lives are changed, how people become from failure to everything. People become God carriers, people become resemblant on God, and how they become the agents of the kingdom of God. These testimonies that are unusual, not from this world, and there are so many thousands of them. So that is what shocked me first.
Это было впервые, когда я увидела, что Царство Божье созидает жизни людей настолько, что они становятся неординарными. Я хотя была 3 года уже в церкви, я никогда такого не видела.
Even though I was a Christian already for 3 years, but I never saw the real representation of the kingdom of God. You see, we could be going to church and we could be religious and not know. We might go to church and not really know the kingdom. I never encountered the kingdom, even though I was a church member in other churches for 3 years, but I never saw the kingdom. I never knew the kingdom. So many people are in churches today, but they have never encountered the kingdom of God. They don't know the kingdom. And that is what I saw. When I met the kingdom of God in the Embassy of God Church, I was shocked because people were resembling Jesus. People were carrying the virtues of the kingdom. People were, people's lives were being transformed to Jesus' image. They were resembling God in their behaviors. That is the biggest testimony of the kingdom of God. Not just testimonies of God's blessings, but how people are carrying the nature of God on the earth.
И именно в тот момент, именно в тот день я поняла, что Царство Божье настигло меня, и моя жизнь не останется прежней.
So, on coming to the Embassy of God, I saw and experienced the kingdom of God firsthand. I experienced the kingdom. I had a first-hand encounter with the kingdom. So many people who are calling themselves Christians today, unfortunately, have never encountered the kingdom. We know the Bible, we know religion, we hear messages, we hear people teach and preach, we shout hallelujah, we receive miracles from God, but we have never really encountered the kingdom. But in this church, I had a first-hand encounter with Jesus, and not just with Jesus, with the kingdom principles, with how kingdom changes people's lifestyle, how kingdom make ordinary men to become like, you know, like God himself.
Я с маленьким ребенком переехала в город Киев, и действительно я получила новую жизнь, потому что с этого времени принципы и ценности Царства Божьего изменили меня полностью. Из человека, который даже не то что с микрофоном на сцене боялся говорить, я в присутствии 3-4 человек теряла саму себя и хотела сквозь землю провалиться. Настолько я не являлась личностью, настолько была низкая моя самооценка.
I was from a person, so through this my encounter with the kingdom of God, I discovered that you can actually build your life. You can reconstruct your life, no matter how weak you are today, no matter where you are at this moment. Like me, I was at a very bad state. I got pregnant, I got a child, I came to this city, to the city with a little baby in my hand, as a 21-year-old girl. And with a little child in my hand, I didn't know where to go, no profession, no trade, no education, nothing. And I didn't know where to go. But since I got exposed to the kingdom principles that pastor teaches, I began to rebuild my life from zero, from foundation, using these kingdom principles. I never knew that before. I couldn't even talk before people. I couldn't even look. I couldn't even have my own opinion. I was not a personality. I was not an individual. I didn't even feel myself. But now, through those kingdom principles and teachings, I began to build my life like block upon block, block upon block, building myself into who I wanted myself to be, to become eventually.
И сегодня я являюсь общественным деятелем. Меня приглашают.
I'm a pressure group leader. I'm an influencer in the society. Right now, I'm being invited to talk to the nation, on the national TV.
Меня приглашают на национальные телеканалы.
I'm right now an expert on TV shows and talk shows in the country that are discussing the problems of the country, and I'm being invited and as expert to hear my own opinion and to contribute to developing and building my country.
Также являюсь правозащитником и внедряю ценности защиты прав и правового менталитета в нашем обществе по всей стране.
Today I'm known as a civil rights defender. I am now defending the rights of people, and you know, people I'm not just living for myself, but I'm actually, you know, a civil rights defender in the country.
Также служитель и предприниматель, и сегодня служу пасторам, и также наше служение, оно распространяется на разные города Украины.
Right now, even though I'm not a minister myself, I'm not a pastor, but I'm a kingdom carrier, so I have a ministry for pastors. I preach to pastors, I teach pastors who are outside of this church and who are outside of the city here. So I teach them kingdom principles on how they could bring revival to their cities. And also, I'm a business lady.
И все это произошло благодаря тому, что принципы Царства Божьего, они изменили меня как личность, и я получила собственное поручение и миссию от Бога идти в общество и внедрять ценности и принципы Царства Божьего в нашей стране.
So I've just told you what the encounter with the kingdom has done for me. The kingdom encounter changed me, transformed me from somebody who was nobody before, from a failure and a weak individual to become a personality. Now I'm a kingdom carrier. Now the kingdom of God has been formed in me. I've gone from a child of the kingdom to become a son of the kingdom. Now as a son, I've been prepared to now go and encounter territories and spheres of influence, mountains in our society, so that I could use the kingdom principles to subdue those mountains, to subdue those spheres of influence. Now, as a son, I cannot keep on sitting down in the churches anymore. I have to go away from the pews of the church and now begin to advance the kingdom of God, to enforce the kingdom of God upon those spheres of influence that I feel I have passion for and God is calling me to. So that is the second part of my story to you, of how I am now carrying the kingdom of God to my world.
Я приведу несколько примеров о том, как можно утверждать Царство Божье, насаждая правильные ценности, истинные ценности Царства в обществе, изменяя культуру в обществе, а также либо решая какие-либо проблемы, которые есть в обществе, в наших городах и странах.
Now I'm going to, my testimony is going to, border on how I, as an ordinary girl, young lady, is using the principles of the kingdom of God to change the culture of my country, to change the culture of my people, and also how, using the principles of the kingdom of God, I am bringing solutions to the citizens of my land.
Например, в нашем обществе есть одна очень серьезная проблема. Каждый год только в Украине 5000 женщин погибают от домашнего насилия со стороны мужа или сожителя. Это смертельный случай. 5000 женщин каждый год. Но каждая четвертая находится в этой проблеме.
Now, the first area, sphere of life that I felt obliged to bring the kingdom of God to is in the area of domestic violence. I'm going to give you a statistic now that is going to totally blow your mind away. You will not believe this, but this is true. In our country, where I live, in the Ukraine, in a country of about 40 million people, less than 50 million people, you can't believe this, 5,000, right? 5,000 people are killed in family disputes and family fights and conflicts. 5,000 domestic violence, 5,000 women die of domestic violence in our country on yearly basis. And I, being a woman, I could not just remain in this country. I cannot keep on living in this country and close my eyes to this tragedy. I cannot be in a country where people are battering their wives, battering them and killing them, and I am a kingdom carrier here. I will not do anything about it. So I started an organization, a nationwide organization, that is to tackle that problem.
И, конечно, как мы могли бы решать эту проблему таким образом. Например, можно было бы помогать женщинам избавляться от их проблем в семьях, а женщинам, которые просто приходят в наши церкви. Таким образом, я посвятила бы свою жизнь тому, чтобы помочь, может быть, 500, скажем, женщинам, которые пришли в нашу церковь с такой проблемой.
Okay. In most countries, the way people resolve this, is that Christians just go and do charity. People, Christians go out and build a house where they a refuge center where they take those people who have been battered or who have been abused. They take them in the house and just help them individually. But that way, you only, out of 5,000 a year that are being killed, you only help maybe 500 in your lifetime. You can only help maybe 500 women that way, if you are going to be doing it individually. But that is not how the kingdom works. That is not how we've been taught the kingdom. We are supposed to change, not just by helping individuals alone, even though we help individuals, but we are supposed to go in a bigger scale and address the issue, the root problem. It's a whole sphere of influence. It's a whole, you know, mountain that needs to be subdued. So instead of just addressing individual problem of ladies, but we address the totality of that problem on national scale as an NGO, a non-governmental organization, and a pressure group.
Я понимала, что я не смогу так жить, понимая, что я не могу изменить кардинально проблему, повлиять на нее серьезно, а смогу заниматься всю жизнь только несколькими женщинами.
Unfortunately, this is what many churches have failed to understand. many churches that are doing charity, they only go to address and help individual lady one by one, one by one, instead of them addressing the issues of the problem as societal groups, as civil society groups. So I started a civil society group that will address the root of the problem and address it on the level of the government and on the level of the media, just in totality, in comprehensive approach to the problem.
И, конечно, эту работу нужно делать, помогать индивидуально отдельным личностям. Но что сделали ли мы? Я организовала общественное движение, которое начало привлекать внимание общества к этой проблеме. Mm-hmm. То есть мы начали влиять не на последствия проблемы, которые существуют в обществе, непонимание личности женщин, о том, что для женщины более важно выйти замуж, лишь бы как выйти, вместо того, чтобы реализовываться и достигать своей жизненной цели. Мы приняли решение влиять на причину, а не на следствие, на саму же проблему как результат.
So we started a civil society group, non-governmental organization that we used to bring awareness to the whole problem of the whole nation. So our goal was to make everybody in the country to be aware of the problem. So we are not just dealing with the consequences of people who have been battered, people who have been, you know, beaten, or people who have almost died, but we were actually addressing the root of the problem, the source of the problem. So we're changing the atmosphere in the country, and we're, you know, changing the mindset of the country, the culture of the country, in regards to men's relationship to women and in regards to domestic violence.
Понимая, что в основе этой проблемы лежат неправильные ценности в головах женщин и неправильные ценности в головах мужчин, мы можем понять, что нашей главной задачей должно быть изменение этой ценности. Извращенные ценности заменить истинными ценностями Царства Божьего. Этим я и занялась.
So the strategy that we use to solve that problem of domestic violence in our country is that we discover that any kind of violence like that affects the behavior of a citizen or of individuals is because of the wrong value system. So I discovered that the ladies are having the wrong value system because they are not pursuing their God-given goal and purposes to become people who discover their purposes and live for their purposes. But most ladies are living just to become wives, to get married, to marry successful people, to successfully, to have children, and those are wrong value systems. We are not created just to have children. We are created to, first of all, discover the purposes of God for our life. So that is the root problem for the ladies and for the men also. They also don't know who they are. They are supposed to be subduing territories and spheres of influence, but instead of that, they are subduing women. And so we needed to change the mindset of the society as a whole. So not just for those who are violent right now, but this whole society.
И в 2011 году мы организовали первый в Украине самый большой масштабный флешмоб, посвященный защите женщин от домашнего насилия, на котором мы показали, во-первых, мы осветили проблему, мы привлекли к ней внимание, и, во-вторых, впервые в Украине именно мужчины встали на защиту женщин и показали свою позицию, что они, как мужчины, готовы поддержать женщин и защитить от этой беды.
So, one of the things we started doing, apart from just doing seminars and teachings and lectures and conferences, is that we started doing flash mobs. And these flash mobs, we do them in public places. We mobilize men and women, and also, you know, begin to stir up the men, so that men will begin to speak out against domestic violence. So for the first time in Ukraine, we started doing public, in public square, right in the middle of transport, right in the main street of the city. We began to make men, women and men stand out against violence, and it's a flash mob that takes attention and catches attention of everybody, and, you know, the whole country will stand still. The TV will cover it, television, media, everywhere. The whole country is talking about it. Those are the kind of ways we started talking about it, raising the problem, and even making men to come to the defense of women.
И да, мы пригласили СМИ, были сняты репортажи, сюжеты, и только в этот день нам удалось охватить 6 тысяч человек. этой просвещением относительно этой проблемы. То есть 6 тысяч человек получили четкую информацию о том, какая есть проблема и что делать, если ты с ней столкнулся.
Это кроме телевидения и так далее.
Да, это вживую лично.
So one event, for example, like that, about 6,000 people will individually be affected by it personally. Not talking about the media and about the mass media, TV and everything. These are people who have an encounter, direct encounter with this flash mob, and that, you know, that is changing the mind and attitude of men to women and removing violence in the families.
И это мероприятие спровоцировало съемку телепередачи, которая транслировалась и в интернете, и на христианском телевидении о проблеме домашнего насилия в отношении женщин. То есть эту тему начали поднимать. После этого меня начали приглашать украинские телеканалы на различные ТВ-шоу. Несколько каналов пригласили для того, чтобы я выступала как эксперт и говорила на эту тему.
So that is one thing, the flash mob. But after the flash mobs, the next thing that we started doing is that we started instigating media interest. So all the media, the television stations and radio stations began to raise, because they have their own topics that they always talk about, but we raised the topic, that the topic of domestic violence must be raised. So all these media outlets began to raise the topic of violence in the family, and they began to make programs, national programs dedicated to these problems. And then all these television programs began to invite me as the expert. So I'm now like an expert and a consultant, civil society representative to solve the problem of domestic violence in our country on TV and through the media of our nation too.
Таким образом, конечно, при поместных церквях и вообще в обществе есть реабилитационные центры, центры восстановления, помощи женщин, но также есть возможность влиять на совершенно другое количество людей на совершенно другом уровне, меняя менталитет и внедряя истинные ценности царства в мышление людей, меняя их судьбы.
Еще раз. Я прошу прощения, я просто считал.
Таким образом, есть...
За церковь что ты говорила?
Есть при церквях реабилитационные центры, центры восстановления, группы помощи женщинам в проблеме насилия. Но также есть возможность влиять на совершенно другом уровне, влиять на совершенно другое количество людей, меняя мышление людей, насаждая истинные ценности Царства Божьего, меняя их судьбу.
Okay, so what Abaria is saying here is that we are not talking, the kingdom of God is different from the kingdom, from the gospel of salvation, in the sense that, you know, in the gospel of salvation, the churches just want to do a good job. They just want to put a pass mark and do some little thing, or that we are feeding the poor in the street, or we are taking care of the woman that was battered, or we are having a house for a few women or a few children, or we are doing, but they don't solve the problem in this nature. They don't solve the problem nationally. They don't solve the root of the problem. But that is what we have done. That is what God, you know, we are talking about. The kingdom of God will not just solve the individual problem, one person or just a few people, even a few hundred people. That is too little. But even though we still have that going on parallel in the churches, local churches, but that is not the idea of how the kingdom works. The kingdom of God is going to the root of the problem. Whatever the problem is, the kingdom of God is going to the core value system of that problem, and then is using publicity, is taking the attention of the whole country, so that the whole country will be aware of that problem, and the whole country will also be aware of the problem and the solution that we bring to it. That is how the kingdom of God works. The kingdom of God should be a total approach, a total solution to the total need of man.
Amen.
Somebody is asking, Maria, I'm sorry, someone is asking here, please, pastor, help me. I want to work with you as a pastor. I'm already a pastor somewhere, but want to work with you. Okay, what do I tell you? Right now, I'm a pastor in Ukraine. And in Ukraine here, you cannot work with me because we speak a different language. You see here, we speak a different language. But I am coming to Nigeria. I am about to move from Europe. I'm moving for good. I'm not just coming to Nigeria to visit. I'm moving to Nigeria for good. And I'm moving to Nigeria for a revolution. My focus is not to start churches, but I know that maybe I will not be able to escape that. But if God speaks to me to start churches, we are going to start churches. But right now, I want to go and change Nigeria as a nation. I want to bring national transformation. I want to bring a revolution over there. I want to do what I've done in Ukraine here. I want to do it over there. So if you are from Nigeria or you are from any other country, I'm already on my way out of Ukraine. So maybe by next year, I'll be away from here. I'll be out of here. So if you say you want to work with me, just write, go to my blog. Go to my blog, sundayadelajablog.com. sundayadelajablog.com. And / Nigeria maybe, or just go to sundayadelajablog.com and you will see Nigerian transformation. You go there and fill out the form, or you could write to me personally if you want to talk to me personally. And you could write to me personally, and my email is pastor@godembassy. It's one word: godembassy.org. sundayadelajablog.com is .com, but my email is godembassy.org. So if you want to talk to me personally, then we could do that. Let's resume talking to Maria. I hope you are enjoying yourself. And if this thing is blessing you, you know, it's a good idea for us to hear from you. Go ahead and write what you think. Go ahead and write about your impression about this kingdom approach. You see, it's one thing for me to say, but you see ordinary members, people from the church who have been taught. And I want to tell you, if you want to invite Maria to your church, if you are a pastor or you are a civil society person, or you want to start something and you want to invite Maria to your country or to your, why not? You know, you can, if you need her or any of the people that were here yesterday, maybe Olena that was here yesterday, or Tatiana that was here, you want to invite them to your country? They are kingdom carriers already. They know what it means to carry the kingdom of God. So any one of them that you want to invite, just write to me, write to me to pastor@godembassy.org, pastor@godembassy.org. We'll be able to help you get them to come over there, maybe to America or to Africa or to Germany or to, you know, let them show you examples of how to carry the kingdom of God. Yes. It is possible to carry the kingdom of God in your country. They will tell you everything. I cannot travel. I don't travel anywhere. But they can travel and come and be a blessing to you. So when am I coming to Nigeria? I might come maybe next year. But you go and register. We'll inform all of you about that, definitely. Yes, Maria.
Мне еще продолжить, пастор?
Yes, please.
Okay. Я
приведу... Надо полностью... Если мы не закончим, если с тобой сегодня, мы тогда на следующий раз начнем.
Хорошо. Тогда я приведу еще один пример о том, как можно изменять ценности в обществе, применяя принципы работы живого царства.
So what I showed, what she's saying is that what she showed to you, what the example that she, the story that she told you is how she, as an individual member of the church, is carrying the kingdom of God to one of the spheres of influence that she has. So she's going to tell you of how she's also bringing the kingdom influence to other spheres of influence as well.
В Украине есть большая проблема и неправильная извращенная ценность в обществе. У нас очень низкий уровень правового просвещения населения. То есть люди абсолютно не знают своих прав. Поэтому их легко обмануть, они не знают, на что они имеют право, и живут в полном неведении. Поощряется беззаконие во всех сферах общества.
Okay. She says, the other thing she's talking about is that she, you know, noticed that in our country, people they don't know their rights, and they don't know what the Constitution says about them. People are being oppressed because they don't know their rights. People don't know the laws of the land, and they don't know the rights that they have. People are taking advantage of them because they don't know who they are. So there is a poor human right awareness in the society. People are not aware of their rights, and the government is taking advantage of them. The businesses are taking advantage of them. The bureaucracies are taking advantage of them. So I decided to bring the kingdom of God there and use the kingdom of God to bring solution to the problem of ignorance in the area of the law, legal ignorances, to put an end to legal ignorance and legal oppression in our country. Just shout it out to Maria.
Mm-hmm.
Just a minute, I want to respond to someone here. I'm seeing Mark Obaino here. Mark Obaino, who says, I dislike you. That is me. He dislikes me. He dislikes me for speaking against Biafra. He said, I dislike you for speaking against Biafra. I will advise you to mind your business. Okay. What do I tell you, Mark? I think that, I spoke my opinion. But I don't dislike you. I love you. And I love every Biafran person. And I love those people, everybody. I love all of you. I love everyone. But to dislike me because I speak my own opinion, you have the right to speak the opposite opinion. You are speaking your own opinion, but I also spoke my opinion. I think, we would live in a better world if we respect each other. I respect your opinion. I'm not cursing you. I'm not hating you or disliking you because of your own opinion. You know, you call people in Biafra call Nigerians zoo and people in the zoo, but even then, I don't dislike you. I still love you, and I still, but I just have my own opinion, and I share my own opinion. So when you say people in Nigeria are zoo, that's your opinion, and I'm not attacking you for that. That's your opinion. So if I say my opinion about the fact that what I think about Biafra, that's my opinion as well. I will advise you to be tolerant and to learn to listen to other people's opinion and not always go personal and not be abusive about people who have their own opinion. We are living in a free world. And because we live in a free world, you know, people will have opinions that are different from yours. That doesn't make you to dislike or hate them. I am going to be one of the greatest blessings to Biafra. You will see when I come to Nigeria. Of course, if the Biafran people will let me come there, if they will not ambush me or try to hurt me or do evil, I will come. I believe in the Igbo people. I believe in the I am one of the greatest supporters of the Igbo people in my life in this world. They are my favorite people. I love them with a passion, and you know, but I still have my opinion about breaking up Nigeria. I think it's not for good of the country. And I have to make my points to point out to my brethren who think that Biafra is the way, to make them my point that Biafra is not the way. And I know a lot of Igbo people who don't support Biafra. So if an Igbo person doesn't support Biafra, it means you dislike that person as well. It means you will hate that person as well. Then you are going to hate too many people. And by the time you are hating everybody, you are going to be hating your family members soon. So hate and dislike is not the way out for Biafra. So, you know, let's just use the principles of the Bible, the principle of love, to resolve our problems. Thank you so much. I'm sorry, I'm going to continue with Maria. Sorry, if you are not a Nigerian, sorry, I got distracted. I think it could be a lesson to all of us anyway. But Maria will continue her testimonies.
Okay. Итак, мы говорили о том, что есть в Украине большая проблема, люди не знают своих прав. И сегодня это выглядит так, что народ возмущен, устал от беззакония. Но в основном люди ничего не предпринимают. Они просто возмущаются, страдают от этого. Но неправильная ценность о том, что не от меня зависит, что изменит в моем обществе, а что я просто живу, потому что общество такое, все плохо, поэтому у меня все плохо. Эта неправильная ценность, она приводит к тому, что люди ничего не меняют в нашей стране.
Yes. Another big problem, like I was saying, in our country here, is the problem of legal illiteracy. People don't know their rights, and people just take advantage of them. Government people take advantage of them. The rich and powerful take advantage of the poor. And the people who are defenseless, people just become defenseless because they don't know the law. And other people are taking advantage of them, you know, and all that. So I decided to stop that you know, imbalance. I decided to put an end to that legal illiteracy in our country, and I decided to educate people about their rights and to let them know that they should not submit to oppression. They should not be oppressed because they don't know their rights.
Имея возможность юридической поддержки, я решила не просто помогать тем людям, которые обращаются ко мне по конкретным юридическим вопросам. Я как человек царства не смогла сидеть спокойно и просто заниматься рутинной работой и не пойти в общество и не изменить эти ценности, не повлиять на эту проблему.
So I joined a law firm that we began to solve the people's problem, but law problem. But as a law, and if you are a lawyer that is here right now, I want you to listen. You could do a law, you could be a lawyer just by attending to your clients and just by resolving individual problems. That is still a way of resolving the problem, just like the church was resolving the problem of people who are in the society one by one. But that doesn't eradicate the problem. It's not the way of the kingdom of God to solve the problem. So even though I was in a law firm that were resolving the problem of individuals, that is what the law firm does. So you have a client, that complains, and you resolve that problem individually. But that is not the way the kingdom of God resolves problem of a society. The way the kingdom of God resolves problem is to approach it holistically and see that whole problem of legal illiteracy as a land of promise or as a mountain that must be subdued, as a sphere of influence. So apart from me just working as a lawyer and as a law consultant in that company, what I was doing was to go out of just doing a law consultation into giving education, law education to the whole society, is to give law enlightenment. To give enlightenment to the society about their rights, about their legal rights. So it's more than just giving legal certificate. I mean, it's more than just giving individual consultation, individual law consultation. This is giving enlightenment to the whole country as a whole. This is bringing, enlightenment to the general public about their rights as, you know, as citizens of the country.
И таким образом с командой поставили перед собой выбор, вызов. Мы поставили перед собой вызов изменить неверную ценность на истинную ценность, что права и свободы человека должны быть поставлены во главу угла и быть основополагающие в нашей стране. Но мы не просто могли бы возмущаться об этом и говорить об этом и обсуждать это, но я решила делать другое. Я организовала клубы правовой поддержки.
The approach we had is that we had in that company some other Christians as well. So what we decided to do, instead of just making money out of people and, you know, and just helping them to solve individual problems, what we've decided to do is to bring the problem of legal illiteracy and oppression, legal oppression of people to become a national issue. So we decided to raise the problem as a national problem and begin to address this on national level and bring in awareness and deliverance to people that way.
Я дерзнула повлиять на мышление людей и помочь понять им то, что они могут что-то изменить в своей жизни и защищать свои права. Что я сделала? Я взяла конкретные правовые проблемы, с которыми часто сталкиваются люди в нашем обществе, и организовала на конкретные темы встречи клуба правовой поддержки, куда люди могли прийти и узнать все об этой проблеме.
So one of the things that we did to resolve this problem is that I started forming clubs of law clubs or law consultation clubs. This is not where people pay money, but these are just like discussion clubs or town hall meetings. So we started all over the country these, you know, town hall meetings where, you know, people, anybody, any citizen could come to and get knowledge and illumination and education and be enlightened about their rights. You know, even in your own country where you are right now, there are a lot of people who don't know their rights. They don't know what the Constitution guarantees them. They don't know what the law says about their rights. And so we started in every region of the city and of the country, we started having these clubs, discussion clubs, where people could come with their issues and we could tell them what the law says about them, and we're changing their mindset and teaching people to claim their rights, to change their attitude and not to allow themselves to be oppressed.
И каким было мое удивление, я была потрясена, что уже на первую нашу встречу пришло 50 человек, которых я до этого абсолютно не знала. И у меня появилась возможность поработать над их мышлением в том, чтобы они начали жить европейскими ценностями, осознавая свои права и ценность себя как гражданина и своего голоса. И они получили конкретные инструкции, как решать ту проблему, на которую была посвящена именно эта встреча.
So we started having discussion clubs. Topic by topic, topical discussion clubs. So if you are having problem with your neighbor, how do you resolve that problem? So we make announcements for a club or a town hall meeting or city hall meeting or regional hall meeting, and everybody in that region, in that area of in that part of the city could come. So my first meeting like that was 50 people. I was so surprised because I thought, you know, maybe nobody would come. So that's the way we started. So we started organizing clubs, raising different questions that people are encountering on a daily basis, and they could come and get law consultation and be educated in how to use the law and the constitution of the country to defend themselves. And we are teaching them as well how to stand for themselves. So that is how we change the whole country, and we are changing the understanding and the mindset of the country and citizens of the country just by forming up this network of clubs all over the country, that where we are bringing awareness of the law and the civil rights of the citizens so that they could stand for themselves.
Таким образом, уже за первые три месяца удалось поработать таким образом над осознанием своих прав и ценностей царства с 350 человеками. Это за первые три месяца. И несколько городов, узнав об этом и увидев результаты, что люди действительно начинают что-то делать, идут и отстаивают свои права, идут и получают то, что им положено по закону, они захотели, чтобы такие же клубы правовой поддержки были открыты в других городах. И уже получилась сеть.
What happened was, and I started by starting one club. So one club giving consultation, giving enlightenment to the whole city. Then, you know, other people started hearing about this. The numbers started growing and the club started coming up everywhere where we are giving people enlightenment, where we are opening the eyes of the people to know who they are and to change their attitude to themselves, to respect themselves, to believe in the laws of the land and to use the laws of the land in the advantage. So if you are a lawyer, instead of you just working for yourself, you could bring the kingdom of God through your profession, through your law consultation, not just to work to make money, but to use it as a field of influence, bringing the kingdom of God to wherever you are, where your passion is, where your specialty is, where you are good. You know, start clubs, start consultation clubs, start city hall meetings, start, you know, gathering people, start empowering them, start opening their eyes. And when you have helped people like that for free, It is a very easy thing for them to receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. When you know you are helping all these women with domestic violence, and you give them help, and you are the one who brought enlightenment to them, and it is easy for you to now introduce Christ to them. When you also bring the Lord Jesus Christ to people, and you know give them their rights, first of all, you let them know who they are. The next thing you do is to now make them know that they have to receive the Lord Jesus as their Lord and Savior. So that is how you spread the kingdom of God with your passion and with your gift.
И я стала делать простую вещь. Это может делать абсолютно каждый. Любую историю, успешную историю защиты своих прав человека я стала делать общественным достоянием. Через интернет, через такие клубы, различными способами. Люди увидели успешные примеры, как кто-то отстаивает свои права. И мы даем им сразу инструкцию, как это делать и им. Я увидела невероятную, колоссальную реакцию только в Фейсбуке. Невероятно. С одной любой проблемы можно сделать целое общественное движение.
Another principle of the kingdom that must be used is that the kingdom of God does not just address individual issues, just like the kingdom, the gospel of salvation does. It is the gospel of salvation that just masters in individual issues only, and we don't solve the whole holistic issue on the mass level. But as a kingdom, as a representative of the kingdom of God, as a kingdom carrier, the goal is to change the mindset in that whole sphere of influence, is to change people's way of thinking. And one of the ways we have done that also is by bringing people alongside to all those clubs and in the media testify. So people come out with stories and testimonies of how we have helped them. So all these stories of how their lives have changed, what help they have got through our social and our legal consultation and legal enlightenment clubs started going everywhere. The whole country started talking about it in social media, on Facebook, TV, and everywhere. So that is how you change the whole mindset of a whole country about the problem of knowing their rights.
И тогда я реально увидел, что на самом деле, если есть темнота, какая-то проблема в нашей стране, это значит, что общество просто ожидает откровения сынов Божьих. И эти сыновья Божьи приходят и приносят свет, и приносят ответ, и решают эту проблему.
What this has taught me is that actually the whole world is waiting for the manifestation of the sons. I, as a son, just step into any kind of problem in the society. If you are a son in the kingdom of God, you can step out like that, especially if you have passion and call in that sphere of life, or you feel burdened even in any area where there's any problem. Everybody is waiting for the manifestation of the sons. And as a son of God, you bring the kingdom principles, you just come to bring light, to change people's mindsets, to bring enlightenment, you bring help to people, and then you share these testimonies, and then you make it be publicized so that the whole nation will hear about the way out. And that is how you deliver a whole land or a whole city or a whole country or a whole segment of the society from the whatever has bothered them and has held them down hitherto.
То есть, чтобы мы не являлись профессионалом, если мы компетентны и имеем решение какого-то вопроса, которое может быть нужно людям, из этого можно сделать влияние на национальном уровне и решать проблему не в жизнях отдельных людей, но решать проблему на уровне страны и влиять на нации.
So you see, the most important thing I want you to understand is that the gospel of the kingdom does not just solve individual problems. That is why we have a lot of people who have answers, but because they are only solving individual problems, the country remains in trouble. The country remains in problem. The country remains under oppression. But if you understand that particular principle, that as a kingdom carrier, you bring solution to all spheres of influence. You bring a total approach to, bringing deliverance to the whole nation, to the whole sphere, to that whole promised land, then you will see that you have having more impact on millions or thousands of people rather than just on a few individuals.
И я также хочу пример привести, который мне очень нравится и очень меня вдохновил, о том, как получается изменить культуру в большой международной компании, в которой работает 60 тысяч человек.
I'm going to stop you on that, Maria. Я буду останавливать Марию на этот, I'm going to stop, I'm sorry, I'm talking Russian to you. I was talking English to Maria and talking Russian to you. I'm sorry. I'm going to stop Maria at this point because wonderful testimony she's given. Very good stories. Very good testimony. And I'm going to ask her to come back next time. Next time we're going to have another person on Saturday. But sometime we'll have Maria to come back and tell us other stories of how she's bringing the kingdom. But just for you to know how individual people are bringing the kingdom of God to spheres of influence. It's not enough for you to just believe me or listen to me, but you could see how ordinary individuals, ordinary children of the kingdom of God are bringing the kingdom of God everywhere. So I want to hear your stories. I want to hear your testimonies. I want to hear your reflection and your impression about what you've heard today. What do you think about this program today? What do you think about this story? What is happening to your mind right now? What's happening to you? What will you tell me? Tell us something. Is there any one of you who would like to exchange the details or take the details of Maria maybe, or get to talk to her or write to her, or you want to know, share some experience or something? Let's hear you. Let's hear what you're thinking. That's why God has put us here, to be a blessing to each other. So let me hear what your decisions are and what you think about what you've heard. And if you have not shared this program yet, if you have not shared the link to this program yet, I want you to go ahead and do that. Please go and share the link to this program And yeah, if because I Pastor Sunday alone cannot be an answer to all the problems, but you know, yet you already met two people already last time. You know, on Saturday, that was yesterday, you met Olena, you met Tatiana, now you met Maria. You know, all these people are kingdom carriers, and they could be a great blessing to you. They could share more with you if you want to talk to them individually. So Joyce De Silva say, good evening, Pastor Sunday. Thank God for your continuous kingdom message. Rejoice De Silva. God bless. Thank you. Annie Atama says, I believe the Holy Spirit has woke me up to watch this. Wow. It is 2:30 a.m. here in Perth, Australia. This is very close to my heart, what Maria is talking about. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Linus Barker says, amazing testimony. It's massive move. Wow. Thank God. Christy Shinasa says, good evening, sir. We are waiting for you here in Abuja, Nigeria. Please, when are you coming? Well, I already answered that question. Ike Shuku says, these reports are like audio visuals of your book, Church Shift. Wonderful. This is church redefined. Yes. Shidi says, great testimonies. Ernest Ebong says, the testimony is really encouraging and an eye-opener. Mark Obiano, okay, I already spoke about that. Nikki Christian says, Pastor, you are so good translating. I bet you didn't miss any words. Made it easy, and we are enjoying Maria's testimony. Yeah, I used to translate a lot, maybe one of the best in the country. Jeffrey Dang says, yes, it does so. He can declare, okay. Okay. Annie Atama says, Maria is right about people being taken advantage of because they don't know their rights and don't know who they are. Yes. OJ Wale said, what a powerful testimony. Emmanuel Ugoshuku said, please, sir, I'm so grateful. It will be an honor to work with you, sir. I have a vision to impact the medical sector of Africa by His grace. This is apart from my ministerial impact. I love you, sir. Please don't forget me. Okay, help me to work with you. No problem. Just need to write the letter, like I said. Annie Atama say, what was Maria's job again? Like I said, she law consultation, she business, and also helping of women that have domestic abuse. Ijeoma says, yes, love. Shidi Obinelo says, you are a generational blessing, not only to Biafra, but to Nigeria as a whole and to the world. Thank you. Shidi says, we need you in Nigeria. I think you will teach the Nigerian government true governance. Mara Izu Ikeshuku says, very well, an entire foundational reconstruction via enlightenment, hence empowering the people through knowledge. Yes. Christy Shinasa Ekwe Ifeshuku says, I am Igbo and I love you, Pastor, because I've attended a meeting you participated in Hilton some years back and discover you are a loaded and anointed man of God and your teachings are changing lives. Thank you. Onoshi Emeke Kwe says, Pastor, thanks for the response on Zoo. God bless you, sir. So much hatred is being peddled around here and it is discomforting. Oyewo Noah says, good evening, Pastor. I'm happy to join you again. Ernest says, this is awesome. Ijeoma says, this is empowering lives forever. Niyi says, great impact you are making, Maria. I'm encouraged by your testimony.
Yeah.
Olukayode said, the problems in Nigeria are mainly associated with bad governance due to the non-participation of the kingdom carriers. If Nigeria divides into 20, the problems will multiply by a double proportion. with the current mindset and mentality. We need renewed hearts to build a country that every tribe and tongue in Nigeria will be proud of. That is what Pastor Sunday is bringing to us. I stand with Pastor Sunday Adelaja. Gift says, God bless you, Sister Maria.
Thank you.
Ijeoma says, this is a great testimony. You are a world changer.
Yeah,
hallelujah. Ogorombi says, Pasiba Maria.
Wow.
Ogorombi Adeyinka. Phyllis Buchanan says, Amen. Let your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Yes.
Amen.
Olukayo, they say, thank you, Marina, for sharing your personal experience with us. Remain blessed.
Bless you.
Shidi says, Maria has set the pace for all of us in the house. You become an example for us. Paul says, I believe God will use this message to change Nigeria and Africa. Amen. Akintade said, I'm getting an insight on what to use here in Tampa, Florida. So God bless. Tiger said, thank you, Maria, for sharing. Shidi said, thank you, Maria. God bless you. And I said, the story has given me a deep thought. It has gone beyond the norm. It's completely practical. I have to watch it again. If your mama said, sir, your teaching is transforming my life. Thank you so much. Thank you too. And then says, Maria, keep it up. Ayo says, this is really needed. People, please keep it coming. I'm encouraged to use my resources and talents to help society and my nation. If everyone who attended was like Maria, it will be easy to take a nation. Oh, yes, no, that is what the kingdom of, that's what the gospel of the kingdom true. Is about.
Yes.
And that is what we are saying, that the churches and pastors must be teaching about the kingdom, gospel of the kingdom. And that's why if you have not shared this link, you need to share it. And you remember every Saturday and every Sunday, every Saturday evening and every Sunday evening, I will be coming with stories like this, with testimonies of how people are practically changing the kingdom of God. I mean, bringing the kingdom of God to change their society. So every Saturday evening and every Sunday evening at the same time. She, Sandra, says, I'm so blessed by your testimony, Maria. Wow. I am now challenged and motivated to be a kingdom carrier. Oh, I want to do more for humanity because I can bear it seeing people suffer because of ignorance. Pastor, please, I want to work with you from Germany. How do I go about it, sir? Write to me. My email is pastor@godembassy.org. Pastor@godembassy.org. Ladi Shorunka said, I met many personalities like Maria in Ukraine. The experiences change how I look at church. Jude said, thanks a lot for the powerful message. Be blessed. Eres Sanara Girl says, I love your ministry and your ministration. Gerald says, Gilbert, love you. Louis Abraham says, I'm a pastor, but also a corporate finance and humanitarian project development specialist. So my heartbeat is both to teach kingdom revelation and socioeconomic transformation. So you mean so much to me. You mean so much to me, and your message is helping become more focused. God bless you, sir. Adelfa Nava say, include me in your prayers from Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Annie Atama said, can I keep in touch with Maria? I do not speak Russian. Yeah, Maria will be speaking to you in English. Yeah. She will be writing to you in English. So if you want to get in touch with Maria, write to me. Write me to pastor@godembassy.org. I will send it to Maria in English, and she will reply you in English.
Yeah, no problem.
Annie Atama, where are you writing from? What country? Annie Atama, what country are you writing from? Yetunde is asking, is Maria on Facebook, please? Yes, she's on Facebook, but her Facebook is not in English. Her Facebook is in Russian language. So it's better to get in touch with her by email. So if you write to me, I will send it to her and she will write you back in English. Lanon Adebayo say, Maria testimonies is life changer. Mm-hmm. I am challenged to remain focused as God purpose for my life. She is a great blessing to the body of Christ.
Hallelujah.
Nkem Dike says, your testimony, dear Maria, is encouraging to us. Very practical and life transforming experience.
Yeah.
Fleur Karine Matif says, awesome testimony. Maria, you are a mighty woman. Mm. She is acting for spreading the kingdom of God in many spheres of our country. This is so encouraging. Any problem in our society can be resolved if we are willing to go. Amazing. Thank you, Maria. Catherine, that's from France. Catherine Rose says, love your ministry. Keep all the good work. Thank you. Okay, thank you so very much, everyone. It's nice being with you. If you have not shared the link, please go ahead and share the link for this program. I actually had two people here today. I have another lady here. She is but she is also a world changer in her own class, but she couldn't get to speak today. And, you know, I have so many other people, right? But they couldn't get to speak. Just Maria was speaking, and that was enough.
Thank you. Bless you.
Yeah.
Bless you.
So that was enough bless today. But they are going to... Yeah. Catherine Rose from Ireland is great. So, they are going to come back on... We are going to come back on... I'm going to come back tomorrow morning. 9:30 our time, that's 7:30 UK time, 7:30 Nigerian time, 2:30 AM UK US time, Eastern time, and 8:30 AM European time. So, and then in the evening tomorrow, I'm going to come back again at the same time, 9 o'clock our time, 7 PM Nigerian British time, 8 PM European time, and 2 PM Eastern time in America. So, so I'm going to be here all week. Then on Saturday, I will come back with one of the girls or one of the other people. And on Sunday, we'll come back also. So thank you so much for your time. And let's go and change our world. The kingdom of God works. The gospel of the kingdom works. Let's go and change our world through the gospel of the kingdom. God bless.
Amen.